tonight.
We cannot make the survival of our auto industry dependent on an unending flow of taxpayer dollars.
GM's top man is forced to walk the plank. Others are put on notice. Shape up or ship out. Is President Obama micromanaging corporate America? What does it all mean for millions of workers kind of caught in the middle? Plus, Madonna adoption controversy. She's in Malawi with daughter Lourdes and wants another girl. Why do so many people think they know what's best for Madonna and child?
How'd it go?
By the way, is it anybody's business? Next on Larry King Live. We have an outstanding panel to kick things off tonight. Representative Thaddeus McCotter, a Republican of Michigan, chairman of the Republican House Policy Committee and a member of the Financial Services Committee. Ed Begley Jr. is here in Los Angeles, the actor and environmental activist, star of Living with Ed on Planet Green Network. Also here is Judge Greg Mathis. He presides over the Judge Mathis Show, but he was born and raised in Detroit, and he has relatives who've worked in the auto industry. And in San Francisco, Mayor Gavin Newsom, Democrat of San Francisco, has warned Congress that some effects to preserve the U.S. auto industry could have the effect, rather efforts to preserve the industry could have the effect of impeding advanced transportation technology. President Obama announced the government's virtually unprecedented intervention in the auto industry earlier today. Watch.
Today I'm announcing that my administration will offer GM and Chrysler a limited additional period of time to work with creditors, unions, and other stakeholders to fundamentally restructure in a way that would justify an investment of additional taxpayer dollars. During this period, they must produce plans that would give the American people confidence in their long-term prospects for success.
Ed Begley drove up to our studios tonight in an electrical car, and he has always been supporter of things environmental. Maybe he thinks that should be tagged onto this. What do you make of this whole thing, Ed?
I think there are clean technology jobs out there. Clean tech is growing leaps and bounds every day. I think they need to make the cleanest cars, the most energy efficient cars possible. And they can do that in Detroit and Flint and Lansing and all those places.
Would you have made that conditional on this bailout?
Yeah, to do as much as is humanly possible to make those kinds of cars. I mean, all the auto companies are hurting, but Toyota's hurting a lot less than GM and Chrysler are right now. And they made the Prius and they made lots of other cars, and they made that car I drove up today.
Congressman McCotter, Bush bailed out the auto industry to start with. What do you make of this move today?
Well, the one concern we have, Larry, back home in Detroit, is what type of further restructuring is going to be necessary in the next 60 days for GM and the next 30 days for Chrysler. We have a lot of working families that are wondering if their job is going to be concluded in those that have to be lost. We have retirees that are worried about their benefits. So our number one concern right now is how this affects the hearth of home within the auto industry.
All right, as a born and raised in Detroit gentleman, Judge Mathis, you're aware of these kind of problems going on?
Very much so.
Have relatives in the auto industry?
Yes, and I'm still in Detroit for the most part. What we have to understand, first of all, is that what we're seeing is a result of the banking collapse because we would not be talking about General Motors and Chrysler being on the brink of bankruptcy had there not been a banking crisis. That's the immediate problem that created this. So you're dumping on the auto industry, but you're handing out tens of billions of dollars to the banking industry with no strings attached.
But they weren't selling cars.
They weren't selling cars because you can't get credit. If you can't get credit, because the banking system has collapsed as a result of predatory lending. But in Detroit, I have many family members who are suffering. And to give you a good example, I have a community center there in Detroit. And for the most part, we train young people to become cosmetologists, hairdressers. Now the door is being kicked down by older adults, middle-aged people who want to take the training opportunities for young people. So it's a lot going on. There's a lot of suffering.
Mayor Newsom, do you think Mr. Wagoner is a fall guy?
Well, I don't think he's a fall guy. This is a guy who drove us off the cliff. Remember, this is a guy who killed the electric car, literally, not just figuratively. I mean, he's had his opportunity. He has his time. And now it's time for Car 2.0. It's time for Steve Jobs or someone of his ilk to come in and reinvent this industry. With respect to the judge, I agree. partially about the context of Wall Street, but the reality is this industry's been suffering for years and years and years as we've been focused on profit in the context of these big cars, these SUVs, these Hummers, et cetera, and that's been at the expense of reinventing this industry, as Ed said and others, that Toyota and Honda and other foreign manufacturers have advanced, and that's why they're in a better position than the American auto industry is today.
Well, it's also because they have protectionist policies, those companies you talk about, the Japanese as well. And in those countries, they have tax policy that is more advantageous to them. So if you include the subsidies that the foreign countries provide to their companies, if you include the protectionist policies, while we engage in free trade, we find other reasons that those foreign companies, as well as health care costs.
Ed, what do you make of Barr? We'll take care of
them. I want to buy an American car. I mean, I had
What do you make of the guarantee? He guaranteed them.
I think he's trying to get people to get out there and buy those cars. I'm trying to get them to make the kind of cars people want to buy. I bought an American car as a GM EV1, and they took that back and they crushed it. You know, I had a Ford Contour that I drove for years. It was a natural gas flex fuel car, and I always want to buy American, and that car had more miles up and down on the rack than it did driving in a horizontal plane. It had lots of problems.
Congressman, what do you make of the guarantee?
I think the guarantee is helpful. Anything we can do to solve the underlying problem of cars moving off the lot into consumers' hands, that's part of the critical problem. All the amount of restructuring in the world, the painful human cost, will not amount to anything if we can't get cars off the lots.
So, Mayor Newsom, what happens from here? Does Chrysler merge with Fiat?
Well, I think that's seemingly inevitable. Remember, Chrysler's owned by a private equity firm, a GM, increasingly by all of us. And that's why I thought it was appropriate that the president, speaking on behalf of GM's largest and newest shareholder, the American public, say, look, good enough isn't. And we've got to reinvent or die. And in this case, he, I think, set a very bold target. It reminds me a little bit of Michelangelo's comment. It says the biggest risk is not that we aim too high and miss it. It's that we aim too low and reach it. And I think this industry has been aiming way too low for too long, and it's time to completely reinvent it. And that requires more than just ingenuity and entrepreneurialism in Detroit and Michigan, as critical as that is for jobs and this economy, but also requires an investment places around the rest of the country, not least of which in the garages of people here in Silicon Valley.
CNN.com/Larry King. Go to that, click on our blog, tell us what you think. We'll share some of your comments later in the show, and we'll take your calls. Don't go away.